lymphatic hypoplastic, which has to do with kidney again. So he has a lot of streamers, cords that go out here, and a lot of yellow. And we have what we call a funnel here, where the collarette just sweeps out into the kidney reaction field. It's also affecting the adrenal gland area. And so with all of the yellow and the main lymphatic type, we really would want to pay attention to the kidneys. So have you had any kidney issues at all, Christoph?
Not necessarily, really. My dad's had kidney stones a few times, and my dad and my brother there has. We find him drink coffee every day.
So remember, as a lymphatic type, and they can become quite acidic, and especially under stress, which pulls calcium out of the bone and deposits it into the kidneys. And this is Dad's side. So just make sure you're drinking lots of raw vegetable juices and alkalinizing. The other thing that we would look at here is the subtype by structure. And he does have some anxiety, a little anxiety tetanic. And so Christoph is a pretty spontaneous person. He's an active person. He's on the go. And I would just say, remember to relax and breathe, Christoph. The other thing we have, we want to look at the collarette. It's somewhat squared. And I would ask Christoph if he has any blood sugar issues. Hypoglycemia or...
I avoid sugar mainly.
Because... But if you ate... Yeah. Oh, they have the best baklava. So if you ate a lot of sweets, though, you might feel some highs and lows. So you've learned not to have sweets. And how is your digestion?
If I stay away from gluten and dairy, it's awesome.
Yeah. But he has to really take care of his digestion because his whole eye draws you to this darker inner area here with some collarette crypts. So can be... poor digestive enzymes, hydrochloric acid.
And ulcerative colitis twice.
Okay, there you go. So he has to really work with possible leaky gut and L-glutamine and probiotics and that kind of thing. Then I would like to talk with you a little bit here about the heart area and any heart problems with Dad or...
No, but his father, he's on blood pressure tablets, but his father died.
So it's on the father's side, some heart issues. And so have you had any heart palpitations at all, or?
No, if I have too much coffee.
Oh, when you see me.
Christoph, I have a heart lacuna too, and I haven't had any problems, but if I were to drink caffeine, so we with heart issues, potential, you have to be careful about caffeine. Okay, as far as the lymph rosary goes, Christos, do you have any ever sinus congestion?
Yeah, I can do. I'm fine at the moment. I remember last time we were in Orlando, we were in a place with no fresh air.
Mm-hmm.
No windows could open. I couldn't breathe.
Okay.
And if I had to carry up, it's very good. It's straight, like, it's so stuffy.
Yeah, so dairy and gluten. So, and that can be an issue. And any aching joints?
My necks can get sore, but it's much, much better since I can stop breathing.
But I think you pretty much take care of yourself as far as nutrition.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. And skin brushing would be important as well. Of course, the skin brushing to move the lymph and the circulation. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, so we talked about the pancreas issues. We see a lacuna here in the pancreas area at 10 o'clock. We always look at pancreas at 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock. The collarette's breaking a little bit. And 8 o'clock. And then there are just cardiopulmonary sorts of things to just kind of work on taking care of.
My brother's got cystic fibrosis.
Okay.
And my grandmother... On my mum's side, I had 6 children, but only 3.
Okay, and we've learned in our urology that 2 or more tophi in the lung area can be a history of some serious lung pathology, possibly tuberculosis somewhere in the family line. don't want to focus on that. We just want to look at what our potentials are. Okay, let's go to his other eye. Could I just go back real quick just for 1 second? There's a little crypt here with a cord going out into the thyroid gland region. And do you have any, have you ever tested your thyroid or any issues with that?
No, so I have in the past, probably 10 years ago, not recently.
Okay. And there again, it's a genetic thing, so taking care of it. Okay, next. Okay, so this is left iris, having to do more with the mother side of the family. And there is that little heart lacuna, and on the mother's side as well. There's a lot of yellow in the rosary, and we have verification of fibers and some cords down here in the kidney reaction field. And there again, just making sure you're getting plenty of water. It's showing the pancreas issues again. A lot of white down here in the cervical spine. How is your back, Christos?
Back's pretty good. My neck's probably the tallest in my back.
It's the upper area. There are some transversals in that area. So, and your circulation to the head area. Yeah, and maybe some slanting board exercises and getting the blood moving up through the head area. There's a tiny little pigment here, and it's affecting the sinus region, but it is brown, so it may be to work with the liver, topolabile to the liver. There's a lot of orange pigment up in the sinus region, but orange has a lot to do with the pancreas too. And then down in here, the adrenals. You're on the go all the time, but you have stopped your work, right? You're not working full time anymore. Except with IPA.
I'm pretty full time. I have actually 2 or 3 days a week. I say that 50 days
a week. Oh, okay.
And I teach weekends.
Oh, you're busy.
Because my kids.
So nourishing your adrenal has been a good thing. The licorice root, maybe. And then these rings, just making sure that you're staying alkaline with the stress that you're under. And not when we have those contraction furs, we tend to drain minerals easily. So making sure you're getting plenty of minerals and trace minerals. Okay.
Color it's breaking because he's got this very powerful pattern on both sides. Let's put them together now. So we've got at the 6 o'clock position is this perfection thing. Perfection is always a writing skill. Have you ever written poetry?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
And it's in relationship. It's really powerful when a man has this in his left eye because it's his relationship to women. So he is looking for, or has looked for, the perfect woman.
He found her.
And he found it. And so that's a really big thing. And one of the things on the shadow side of what this pattern can do is a lot of times there is an unconscious relationship between perfection and love. Some people are aware of it, that if something is perfect, now I can love it. Or if it's perfect, it can love me. And so, but there is some kind of a wired thing. You have to explore it in your own self about how this perfection is affecting. And in relationship, what it does is it's a reason and to not allow yourself to open because this person, they find fault. So perfectionists, if you're a man, you have this in your left eye, or a woman and have it in your right eye, you're looking for Mr. or Mrs. Perfect, and that means love. And if they don't meet your standards of perfection, then you don't have to open. It's one of the greatest sabotages to intimacy there is. It's called pure control, and it's in the mind, and you get to write the script. So if they get 100 things right, you get to find, or 99 right, you get to find one thing wrong and say, see, I told you. And it's all interior many times. And so you just won't open because it's, quote, not safe. But the reality is, it is just a defense mechanism. Let's go to the other eye, please. So he's got actually more probably structural components in this eye, in his right iris. And as an emotional type, when you get, when particularly a man has more structure, even a woman, it becomes the matriarch, but when it's a man, he has a very powerful mind, because this actually adds to the stimulation of the left brain. But he wants to see his ideas take form. This is the engineer eye. This is the mind that really can organize things quite well. And he's going to be obviously multifaceted, multidimensional in how he does that because of his shakerness. But it's a powerful pattern. Let's look here. If we draw a line straight across, we can see that he's got all these lacuna and actually kind of more structure going on in the top of the eye. And in the top of the eye, that's more of the spiritual aspiration. You have a powerful harmony pattern. And this is philosophy and ideals. And so this is a man that, I mean, this is a great president because he's a visionary. And he's thinking about the future. He's, at times, it's great you're into the body and the Bowen therapy and all that because it's brought you down into the body. But your natural tendency is to dream, is to envision, and to want to create a better future. And one of the challenges for that is that he can sometimes set his goals too high, so they're not attainable, and then he gets disappointed and burnt out. And we all know that Shaker flowers have trouble following through, and they'll initiate something, but then they get burnt and bored, and they let it go. So we've got to encourage him to not think too far ahead and to create goals where he can win. It's got to feel, but it's like, that's not very exciting because then I don't have a challenge. He's got a big smile on his face.
The perfect president.
He is. In this sense, this has to be jumping out at everybody. Yeah. Right? Particularly because the energy flows out of the pupil, it flows around the collarette, and because it's energy, it looks for the place of least resistance. And this is going to flow like water right through this area, which has to do with his own self-image. It's going to give him a gift with his hands, fine motor skills. Yes, building things. Not really.
My wife's the builder of things.
What do you do with your hands?
Not much.
Oh, I love gardening.
Love gardening. There you go. Getting into the earth. Well, what this pattern, does this man appear to you to have a low self-esteem?
No.
When you have this pattern, it's going to go one of two ways when it's this pronounced. They're going to go into the victimhood. That's not what we're seeing here. Or they take the energy and they say, I'm going to show you, Father. I'm going to show you who I am. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. And I'm going to make something of myself. So I'm going to overcome this feeling like I couldn't do enough to bond and please with my Father. This is gestation. This is feeling like you wanted a girl and he was unplanned. This is the ninth month. So this place about fitting in. So he's actually going to create his own reality to fit in. And he's going to excel at whatever he does as a way of overcompensating for the part of him that's the little wee one that felt like he didn't do enough. Or remember, children blame themselves when they don't get their love reflected back.
I was very much like that till I was 16.
Okay. And so what happens then is that he shifted at something, and 16 is the end of that cycle and starts the new cycle in the timelines chart. And so he goes into the next phase of life, which had to do with extremes. So I'm sure he went from that place to just blowing the doors off of it for a while. And he can do that well.
What's renumbing?
So recognize that a lot of times this pattern will come out, and it's in his right eye. So he, and I'm thinking about more career and the physical world rather than in relationship. And so what's going to happen is he is going to always be working to prove himself, and he's going to be working hard, and he's to fulfill this vision and this goal so that he can create his own identity in this place that's truly himself.
Wow. Nice.
29. My first wife died of brain tumors around then. So we were married for 2.5 years. We didn't have children. But yeah, that was a difficult time, but those times shape you.
Yeah. Wow.
See where this line comes from and goes to. When we're looking straight at Christoph's eye, this is left eye, and you can see this marker. Now, Tony told us that this is through the heart area, and so true. Sometimes you'll see one that comes up very close to the edge of the iris and travels all the way. If it's very close, it's a lymphatic sign. And that's for another day. But this, now if we could go to the lower left photograph of the scleroma. Okay. Now this is right under your left eye. Okay, this is kidney. The Y shape shows that in your dad's side of the, I'm sorry, this is your mama. This is your mom's side of the family. They had issues possibly with gout, kidney stones, aggravating kidney problems, but not deadly kidney problems. This is pancreas. There may have been blood sugar issues with the gold in your eyes, undoubtedly. And then this is the large intestine, really from the waist of a person downward. This is the left side of the transverse colon, the descending colon. So then let's go to that lateral left again, if we could. This line extends upward beside his eye, and it's a bowel line that extends upward. Then if we could go to the superior left. This is on the lateral side of the iris. Okay, it extends here. Now, that began in the bowel, and that Christoph mentioned, his digestion's fine if he really leaves off the dairy and, was it the wheat?
Gluten.
Dairy and gluten. When he doesn't leave off dairy and gluten, it goes right through the heart area, affects the heart, affects his digestion, affects his nervous system. How does it make you feel?
Oh, when I eat one thing, I'm just tired and sluggish and
okay.
Yeah. Maybe a bit sad.
Okay, a little sadness. That would fit with the nervous system. The nervous system area is here on the left side. Now this is upper left and right. This is left side. That's the way a bump on the head's represented. That was front side, and it was more to the left. Is it showing more in the left eye? This is pituitary, but that line then crosses into the area of the esophagus and the stomach, the way this has turned, you've had quite a problem with digestion in the past. And we know it was in the past because see how this is all faded. As things get better in sclerology, we see a fading. Now this is the other side. Bump doesn't show on this side. There's some sinus irritation. There's the right side of the pituitary. This was the left. We all have that marker. It's one of the landmarks. Nervous system on the left. Now this is upper stomach, right, upper stomach, left. Now this is in the neck. What happened to you? That usually doesn't connect. These are cervical nerves. It looks like a neck injury.
I don't think I had an injury, but I have had a tight neck.
Okay, a tight neck. Okay, that would fit. And this is...
I haven't fallen or anything.
Okay, good. Now this is the jaw. A little bit of pinkness right through the jaw. Right side and left side, maybe a tension or maybe around your teeth at night. That type of thing. And then if we could do the medial pictures. A lot of good health, a lot of good things in all of you. Okay. Wanted to show you the shape of these lines. Now they're landmark lines also. This is in the nerves. This is another marker for the cervical nerves along the back. There's lower back. He holds tension, like Kathy did, right between the shoulder blades. This is cervical nerves. Now thyroid, this is a thyroid marker. Stronger on the left side than the right. May have been an issue in your dad's family. But look at the shape of the veins. See how they twirl? And then even in some places, almost look like a thread that's looped and twisted. That shows that in the family there is a tendency. Now it's more, the twisting is more so on the left eye, which indicates the mom. So the mother's family may have hemorrhoids, varicose veins, little spider veins, that type of thing. I don't see big issues with the circulation, but small things. The pain vessel in the lower back.